visited the Greater Louisville Council of Blind Roundabout to share information and answer questions about these new cards, who needs them, requirements for obtaining them, costs, and much more. Melissa lives in Crescent Hill, and many years ago, she served as our elected official on the Louisville Board of Aldermen and, as such, visited with us at the Kentucky Council of the Blind Convention on several occasions. Because information about these IDs will be of interest regardless of where you live, we are bringing you her comments on page 2. Thanks to Adam Rushival for editing this segment for Soundprints. And on page 3 is the Soundprints calendar. Page 2.
Well, our speaker is here. Melissa Rashan is going to speak with us about IDs and what changes are going to happen in the ID cards and what we need to know about them. I'd like to welcome you, Melissa.
Wonderful. Thank you, Deb. I asked Deb where the meeting was, and she told me, and she said, you won't have any problem finding it because you all make a lot of noise. And that is true. So I work for David Nicholson, and David Nicholson, his title, it's a long title, he is the Jefferson County Office of the Circuit Court Clerk. Isn't that a long name? Well, here in Jefferson County, we elect two elected officials countywide that have the term clerk in their name. One is the county clerk, and the person who currently holds that office is Bobby Hostclaw.
She was here last month.
She was here last month? Oh, that's great. Well, Bobby helps you get the license tag that goes on the back of your car. Okay, that's one of the things she does, and she also runs our elections. The office of the circuit court clerk, where I work, that office is currently held by David Nicholson. He issues driver's license that go in your wallets and IDs. So that's confusing. Can you imagine how many calls we take every day of people wanting to know about card tags that go on the back of your car? And we have to send them over to Bobby's office. Now, I do want to tell you before we start talking about IDs, the other things that the Office of the Circuit Court Clerk does. They run all of the courts here in Jefferson County. We have 40 courts. They are open 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. And the number one reason they are always open is a sad reason, and that's usually domestic violence intake. So the court has to be open. We collect millions of dollars in fees a year. We process all of the court and retain all of the court records. And about 156,000 new cases are filed in our court system every year. So there is a big function of that office that just has to do with the courts. And he also runs the Driver's License Bureau, and that's where we get our IDs. And in Jefferson County, we have 6 locations. Do most of you all go to the Bowman Field location?
Uh-huh.
Or the downtown one? Okay, I'm just wondering which one is close for you. Now, and for most of you, have you all heard about this new Real ID coming?
Yes.
Let's see a show of hands if you've heard about it. Oh, everybody has, so you all know it's coming. So there are going to be a lot of changes, and I'm going to talk to you about the big changes that are coming down the pike. Now, will most of you all be applying just for the ID, or there are some people here who will need a driver's license? So everyone's looking for the ID. Okay. So we're going to talk about what are those huge changes that are coming with this new process. Well, in the past, when you walked into Bowman Field, you walked up to the counter. They asked you, do you need an ID? You said yes. You gave them, they took your photo. You walked to the end of the counter. You paid. You waited a few minutes. And they gave you an ID and you walked out. It was that simple, right? That simple. Okay, so now let's talk about how it's going to change a little. Now when you walk into our Driver's License Bureau, you're going to walk up and there's a smart pad. And so for those of you who have someone with you that can help you operate that pad, great. Otherwise, we have wonderful deputy clerks that will help you operate that